Here in Seoul, South Korea, government officials are growing increasingly wary of threats posed by North Korea's development of nuclear weapons and other types of missiles. Within days, the North Korean government is scheduled to launch a multi-stage rocket. U.S. officials say the rocket is capable of reaching Alaska. But despite this growing tension, South Korean officials say they're still confident that one day the two nations will become one again. South Korea's Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Trade has created a soft diplomacy program called Vision 3000. In exchange for North Korea's denuclearization, the South will help the North achieve per capita income of $3,000. Thousands of defectors have left North Korea and have settled here in the South. Many of these defectors say they hope the process for reunification is a gradual one and point to Germany as a model for reunification.
I sincerely believe that if we collaborate to teach North Koreans about the right capitalism, right financial and economic markets, and if we can show what the international dignity and the courtesy is, they will be opening up their markets, and I think we can lead them into a peaceful process toward unification. I would like to tell all those listeners or the viewers who will be watching this video that I hope all of you can provide us strong support for the future unification of Korea.
Among members of the younger generation, who have never known a unified Korea, hope for reunification is strong.
We just say like this, let's consider about the cost and benefit. But the conclusion is, looks simple. It has great benefit, I think.
I think maybe South Korea and North Korea unification is helpful to stronger nation.
Next month's rocket test could be the next major step in an ongoing struggle between the North, the South, and its Western allies. I'm Carrie Sheffield with WashingtonTimes.com.